Have you ever wondered how it is that statin medications, a heart medication, can have so many different side effects? Well, this week we're going to take a look at a cautionary tale, and maybe it'll help you understand. Stay tuned. This week I'm going to do something a bit different than what I've done before. We're actually going to tell a fable, a fairy tale, something of that sort. And then at the end, we'll take a look back and see what it taught us. So let's get to it. So as you saw from our introduction, your high priest, a very educated man, has come to you and just told you that you're producing too much of an evil substance in your chemical factory. And he shows you this chemical factory and how it works. You look at that and you say, wow, the chemical plant has gone haywire. Look at how much of that dangerous chemical it's producing there. But you notice there's a couple other byproducts of this chemical factory, and they seem to be beneficial or at least benign, so you ask about them. Well, your high priest shows you another motto, and he shows you that they've got this magical substance that gums up the works at the chemical factory. The dangerous chemical output is reduced to a safe level. I mean, they'd like to eliminate it completely. They say they can't do that. And he admits, well, you know, it's unfortunate. The important beneficial chemicals also get reduced. That's just collateral damage. For example, that CoQ10 stuff that you see getting reduced, that could lead to a little bit of mitochondrial dysfunction. He assures you that you'll adjust to this. Besides, CoQ10 reduction occurs with aging. So this is a perfectly natural thing. It's just happening a little sooner than it otherwise would have. Anyways, we can treat any problems that come up with more chemicals. And then he adds, by the way, don't get involved with any strenuous exercise. So you say, okay, go ahead, let's start this chemical treatment that's going to gum up the works and stop this dangerous stuff from being created. So you allow this new wonder substance to be introduced into the manufacturing process, and you wait a while and other things seem to be happening. You call on the high priest to explain, this isn't the collateral damage that you told me about, so what's going on now? So the high priest admits, well, you know, we really can't deliver this miracle substance as directly as we wish. We kind of blanket the entire realm with it, but don't worry, it gets to the factory eventually, but we just kind of have to drop it from the sky and it kind of gets around everywhere. I mean, after all, it is a wonder substance and it's doing an important job of stopping the chemical production as intended. It's just that it has a few unintended consequences, but they're not too bad and we can get used to them. You know, for example, you see at the mobility plant next door, it's taking a few hits and there's something really weird going on in there, but you just have to put up with a little pain here and there. It's part of being responsible for the health of your realm. So you steel yourself to put up with that pain, and you notice there's still a few more things going on, and you call the high priest in again, ask him to explain what's going on, and he tells you, well, there's a little bit of a chemical spill here. He says, you see those barrels near the factory? Well, they have some volatile and dangerous substances in them, like warfarin and niacin, and worst of all, grapefruit juice. And they kind of interact with our wonder substance. But don't worry about that either. The various sources tell us there's only about 80, maybe it's 400 problematic substances that interact with our wonder substance. So you have to give up grapefruit juice. That's just the cost of being healthy. So you go ahead and you give up your grapefruit juice, you reduce your exercise, you tolerate muscle pain, but something's still not quite right. You can't put your finger on it, but you return to the high priest. You find that you're unable to sleep, always in a fog, you can't think clearly. The high priest is absolutely stumped. The wonder drug doesn't cause this thing, he absolutely assures you. There's no remaining source of adverse effects. So you're obviously under stress and just maybe you need some drug treatment to deal with your stress. You're an experienced politician. You know that when things are going wrong, sometimes you have to take a step back and just get back to the basics. So you go back and you look at the manufacturing plant, the chemical plant again, and independent of everything else, and you take a good close look at it. And one thing occurs to you that you haven't thought about is you looked at the side effects from the other chemicals being reduced. You looked at the side effects of this wonder substance getting where it's not supposed to, and you've looked at the side effects of this wonder substance mixing with things that it wasn't supposed to. But one thing you haven't checked is, are there any side effects associated with a low level of this so-called dangerous chemical? So you look up the side effects, the adverse effects of that, and you see that the symptoms of having a low amount of this so-called dangerous chemical are exactly the ones that you've been feeling. So maybe this dangerous chemical isn't so dangerous after all. At that point, you fire the high priest, you throw him down a well or something, and you stop the delivery of the wonder substance into your factory. And for the first time since you started this process, you feel free. You feel good. And that's the end of our story. But it's not the end of what we might learn about it. So we're going to look at this chart of different categories of adverse effects. It's one that I personally made up myself. It's really not useful beyond the confines of this video, but let's look at what it is. So we're going to start with category one. And those are the first ones that we came across. And those are adverse effects from the direct action of the counter substance acting as intended. In other words, there was that collateral damage I talked about that went along with it. The next category is the adverse effects from the counter substance acting on parts uninvolved with producing the so-called dangerous chemical. In other words, when it gets into other factories within your realm. Category three are the adverse effects from the counter substance interacting with other chemicals or nutrients found within the treatment zone. And I might add maybe some genetic conditions also. And then finally, we're going to skip back up to category zero because those are the adverse effects from the counter substance achieving exactly what it was intended to achieve. And why is this important? Well, it's important because the response to these adverse effects is going to be different depending on what mechanism, what vector it used to produce these adverse effects. So we'll take a look at them in order. Category three, if that's happening to you, you have to perform some trade-offs and remove the offending chemicals and nutrients, or possibly remove the so-called wonder substance. If you're having category two adverse effects, you might try other versions of the wonder drug. Maybe they won't impact these auxiliary areas as much as the one you're taking. There's six of them to choose from. Don't inquire about that seventh one. It's not available anymore. That'll be the subject of another video. If you're dealing with the category one side effects, you have to try other not so wondrous substances that do the same thing, maybe not quite as well, but possibly fewer adverse effects. And if you realize that your adverse effects are actually from this wonder substance doing what you've been told it will do, well then you've got to get off all chemical reducing treatments. This dangerous chemical maybe isn't as dangerous as we thought. So how does this apply to statins? Because obviously, in case you missed the analogy, we've been talking about statins all along. Our category three are adverse effects from statins interacting with other medications or nutrients, and I should have added genetic conditions here. So the treatment would be to perform the trade-offs and decide if you can remove some other medications, whether the statin is more important than some of the others. If not, it may mean getting off statins. The category two adverse effects is from the statins acting on organs and tissues other than the liver. In other words, acting directly on your muscles. Now, if that's the case, yeah, you may try other statins, but definitely not cerivastatin. That's the one that was pulled from the market, and that's a big point, like I said, I'll get to in a future video. If it's adverse effects that come from the statins interfering with other legitimate functions of the liver, at that point, you've got to try non-statins because they're all going to do approximately the same thing within the liver. You might try bempedoic acid, Zetia, PCSK9 inhibitors, bioestrogen sequestrants, a few other things. If you have familial hypercholesterolemia, there's other things that you can do. And then finally, if the adverse effects are actually from low cholesterol, then your treatment is just get off all artificial cholesterol reducing treatments and you use lifestyle changes to improve your lipid panel quality. You notice I didn't say anything about lipid panel quantity, in other words, total cholesterol. But if you have a lot of oxidized LDL, that sort of thing, you may want to be improving your lipid panel quality, and that's best done with lifestyle and exercise for many people. So maybe, just maybe, the manufacturing plant's working as designed and it only needs a bit of what we'll call employee training in the form of exercise and diet. This doesn't work for everyone, we admit that. The example I always use is familial hypercholesterolemia, where cholesterol reduction may be warranted. One treatment to really avoid is polypharmacy, taking a drug to treat the side effects of another drug, and then it will have side effects, and you'll go down a tree of drugs and treatments where statins are at the root. You take three different things to handle the side effects of the statins, and each of those, you'll take three different things. It's just a pyramid structure. There's just no place that it would end. So what was the purpose of telling you this tale and coming up with these categories? Well, first of all, it's to give us a different way of looking at adverse effects. They're not just variations on a single theme. Now, this categorization, that taxonomy that I showed you, that's something I made up for the purposes of this video. It probably has no real usefulness outside this video. In other words, you can't go to your doctor and say, well, you know, this is a category one effect. That's not going to mean anything to your doctor. They'll look at you like you've got five heads. What are you talking about? Because it's not something that's out there in the medical community, and nor do I claim that it should be. But it is a way of looking at it for us as patients so that we can determine where our problems are and what is the best response to this. And then again, polypharmacy as a way to address adverse effects, it's rarely the answer. So these are the things that we've got to avoid. So that's what I've got for this week's video. A little different than what I usually put out. I hope you enjoyed it and didn't mind indulging me a little bit for it. And if you appreciate this content, please like, share, subscribe, hit the notification bell so every Friday morning at 6 o'clock you get notified that I posted something new. And comment on this topics or others that you'd like me to cover. Just comment on your story. I actually pick up a lot of new topics from people's comments, even when they're not saying you should cover this. I was like, oh, there's something I should cover. And if you haven't seen this video, I recommend you take a look at it now. Thanks for listening.